Good morning, I am Antonietta Del Bove. I am a PhD student from the University Rovira e Virgili in Tarragona, Spain, and the Catalan Institute of Human Paleoecology and Social Evolution. Today, I'm glad to present a talk about the sexual dimorphism in human crania by using a new automatical protocol. The work is supervised by Dr. Antonio Proficco and Professor Carlo Lorenzo. From study published in literature and day-to-day operation, physical anthropology estimates the sex of cranial remains by using a visual method approach on score, so based on morphology. Many papers have found a strong signal for sexual dimorphism in the glabellar region, in nuchal crest, in the mastoid region, and the orbital margin. In the last 20 years, with the increase of geometric morphometric methods, different studies focused on quantifying the sexual dimorphism and exploring the implication of the variable sex in the skeletal remain. Despite this, the sexual dimorphism is a hot topic in different fields of anthropology, like forensic anthropology, bioarchaeology, and paleanthropology. In this communication, we have two main objectives. First, show a new protocol landmark basis to identify the most dimorphic anatomical trait. Secondly, to apply the new method on a sex no collection in order to detect the anatomical trait of crania most sexually dimorphic, comparing the result with the current literature. In this work, we used 193 crania balanced from female between female and male of adult individual of no sex from collection from the 20th century. The age of the sample range between 20 and 50 years old. The samples come from different repository in geographic area is Europe, North America and South America. Three collections come from Anthropological Museum of Florence University, one from Giuseppe Sergi Anthropological Museum of Roma La Sapienza University, one from the Spanish Olorich Collection, one from the Terry Collection, it's a Smithsonian Natural Museum of Natural History, and one from La Plata Museum of Natural History in Argentina. To acquisition, the acquisition of 3D model of crania was obtained via photogrammetry from the Italian collection using Agisoft PhotoScan software and using CT scan for the other repository. We selected only the external surface of crania with the use of Amira software. To acquire the entire external surface of the sample, we used 15 landmarks and 1,000 semi-landmarks. All the analyses are performed in R with the use of Morpho, R, GL, Arotron, and etc. The automatical protocol consists we defined around each semi-landmark a patch with 20 closed semi-landmarks. On each patch, we performed a procrustes analysis. We ran the analysis 1,000 times, each iteration for each semi-landmark. In detail, on each module defined by 20 semi-landmarks, we applied a linear discriminant analysis to calculate the accuracy in classifying sex. At the end of the process, we calculate the mean accuracy of each semi-landmark in detecting sex. Lastly, the value of accuracy is converted into a color map. We create three different color maps. The first is for central side. For all the maps, the yellow colors indicate the high accuracy in detecting sex. Contrary, the lower accuracy is indicated in blue color. In other words, the most dimorphic anatomical traits are yellow. The second map is analyzing the shape space. This means we eliminated the information about sight from the analysis. So, in this case, we can appreciate which traits show a different signal for sexual dimorphism. The last map is in the form shape. This means shape plus size. Summing the information of shape and size, we got an increase of the accuracy. For this reason, it's more yellow on the image. Now we plotting the total accuracy on the three maps with the violin plot. We can appreciate as the higher accuracy is in the form space, followed by shape space and size. Now, in detail, we can discuss the result in anatomical key. It's a very interesting analyze the map of the master region. It means that size is the main factor in separating male and female, as previously reported in the literature. Now, for the face, we can see different in the accuracy by taking into account or not the variable size. The nasal region is dimorphing only if you include the size in the analysis. On the contrary, the frontal bone and the zygomatic arc are very dimorphic. The frontal bone, it's very important in detecting sex. As we reported in my previous work published last year in AJPA, it improves the signal around the glabella. The signal is very clear only when we consider the shape and not the size. The other view is the cranial base, the mastoid, like we talked before, the mastoids are good makers for sex, but also the zygomatic arc and the region of the temporal mandibular joint. On the other region, the signal appears really homogeneous. The last view is the posterior region of the cranium. We noted the total absence of signal for the sexual dimorphism from literature. We know the parietal bone are not the best indicator for sex signal, but the lack of signals in the occipital crest surprises us more. And to conclude, we receive good feedback for the frontal bone and from the zygomatic arc, for the clavella, so for the mastoid, but we not receive the good feedback for the occipital bone and in general the posterior part of the neurocranium. But in sum, we can talk very good with the automatic approach presenting in this communication, because shows that it's easily reproducible method can be applied not only from the crania and not only to study the sexual dimorphism. The main advantage in using this method is the possibility to study the sexual dimorphism without the analysis in specific feature, and at the same time it's a very interesting the study of the interaction between sex and size. Before to conclude, I'm very grateful with all the museum who helped me for this investigation. In particular, I'm very thankful to Anthropological Museum of Florence, Anthropological Museum of Roma La Sapienza, and I'm very grateful with Dr. Lee Kopp for the collection, the Terry Collection, and Lumila Mendene for La Plata Collection, and the Bio Anthro Talk. Thank you very much for attention.